A lot of YouTubers these days like to drop their S25 Ultra tips and tricks videos on day one, and I'm definitely guilty of doing this myself in the past as well, but it really doesn't make sense to me because the real gems only really show up after a couple of months of usage. So today I'm going to share with you my top S25 Ultra tips and tricks after almost 6 months of usage, and it's just simple things like this. If you grab your S Pen, draw a straight line and hold for a few seconds, Samsung will auto straighten that line for you, making your notes and annotations look a lot neater with little to no effort. And then my second undervalued feature on the S25 Ultra is actually the voice recorder. Once you record, say, a meeting, you can then transcribe, summarize, and even translate, and you can also search by keyword to jump to specific points in that meeting. It's an incredibly powerful feature to have directly on your phone. And the biggest thing for me is that other AI transcription apps will charge you a small fortune for these services. It's not perfect. Samsung's got a little bit of a way to go, but the fact that it's free and definitely usable at this point is a big win for Samsung. So I definitely recommend checking it out if you haven't already. Third is kind of a must-have setup for the S25 Ultra, and that is the one-handed mode. Now, I'd recommend setting up this feature to be active by double tapping the home button on your S25 Ultra. This appears to be the easiest way of getting to this feature in a quick pinch. Once you've activated this setting, you can go ahead and resize the one-handed mode as well to fit your specific hand size. And whatever you resize it to, it will remember that size, so you don't have to keep changing it every time you activate one-handed mode. Just a really simple, quick quality of life setting you can turn on for your S25 Ultra. Now, fifth is One UI 7 has brought some amazing features to calls, including your live translation, summarization, text to call, and then your call recording. To do all this, you need to find a friend and then give them a call. Once you do this, you'll see a few options come up during the call. On the left hand side, you'll see your call recordings. Tap this, and then the user on the other end will hear a "this call is being recording" sound. Tap it again to stop the recording. Then there's also the call assist button. If you tap this, you'll be greeted with two additional features: text call and live translate. A text call will let the other person know you're using an assistant when it's activated. Then you can literally just text instead of actually having to talk. This might be handy when you're in a quiet place where you can hear someone through your earphones but can't actually speak at that moment in time. And then of course you've got your live translation, which kind of does what it says on the tin. My sixth tip is still on calls, and this is another feature you might really want to consider using. When you're on your call with your new friend, swipe down from the top right corner and you'll see the option mic mode. Tap this and you'll see focused. This just helps eliminate some of that background noise and really enhances your voice so people can hear you a little bit easier, particularly helpful if you're outside in, say, a really windy environment. Tip number seven, and please do subscribe if you are enjoying the video. This one is a really important one, and it's actually one of my top tips for anyone getting any new phone really, and it's have an eSIM at the ready. I say this because there's tons of networks out there that provide eSIMs at a discount and sometimes even free welcome offers. I usually just use and abuse these sorts of offers as and when I can find them, especially when traveling. My last trip to Marrakesh, I actually used Saley and actually managed to get away with just using the welcome offer for the whole holiday. It also meant I didn't really need to physically buy an eSIM at the shop or wait for an airport. So making use of the eSIM feature on your S25 Ultra is really important. And I'd say equally important is having one of these eSIMs ready to go. I'll put a link to Saley in the pinned comments so you can use the exact same one that I did on my last trip. Now, number eight is equally as good and a really good quality of life setting to turn on, and that is fix your screen timer. And I say this because there's a better option. By default, your screen timer will likely be set to around 30 seconds or so, but if you go to display, screen timeout, you'll see a bunch of different times to choose from. And at the very bottom, you'll see an option that says keep the screen on when viewing. This will use your front camera to detect when you're actually looking at your S25 Ultra, meaning that it's not going to turn off when you're in the middle of reading an article or watching a video. Speaking of fixing annoying things, my ninth tip is fix the Google Assistant voice. Despite all the recent advancements in AI, Google Assistant still sounds like trash. So if you go to your Google Assistant settings, scroll down to Assistant Voices and then Sounds and select Orange, this gives the Google Assistant a much less robotic voice in my opinion, and this applies to your Google Home devices as well. So if you've got a Nest speaker, it's also gonna work on that too. I definitely recommend doing this because it just makes Google Assistant sound so much less annoying. Now, on the subject of Google Assistant and Gemini, my next tip is a really important one and one that kind of made me feel a little bit stupid when I discovered it just last month, and that is if you download the Google One app, you actually get a 6-month free trial for Gemini Pro or Google One. This will save you around $20 up to $100 over a 6-month period. And if you're already paying for it, they'll even give you a partial refund for that month and then just continue on your subscription for 6 months with little to no hassle. So definitely worth downloading the Google One app and just seeing if you've still got that available. Gemini 2.5 Pro is actually really decent, and I believe it actually scores highest over ChatGPT and other AI models in loads of different categories. So definitely worth trying out. My 11th tip is a bit of a controversial one and might seem a little bit counterproductive, but it does make a difference, and that is turn off RAM Plus. A lot of people don't realize this, but RAM Plus can actually slow down your phone. It uses your internal storage as virtual RAM, which is way slower than actual memory. So head into your settings, your battery and device care, memory, RAM Plus, and switch it off completely. Your phone will likely feel snappier afterwards, especially after heavy multitasking and gaming. Number 12 is a seriously underrated one, and one that I feel a lot of you are just gonna skip over, but you really shouldn't. It's spend more time setting up your routines and modes. Once the initial setup is done, you'll be amazed just how much it can start to save you a little bit of time here and there. And to be honest, they'll make your life way easier too. There's so many cool things you can do, but an example of one that I have is to automatically bring up Google Maps when my phone connects to my car's Bluetooth. And then I can also set up locations, so when I'm at the office, so my phone connects to the Bluetooth, it'll automatically start navigating back home for me and vice versa. So definitely worth checking out and really getting creative with the things that you can do with routines. And speaking of routines, number 13 is a really great tip for some of you, and that is use focus mode for deep work or just some peace and quiet. Digital wellbeing settings have a hidden focus mode feature that lets you pause distracting apps like Instagram or YouTube during your working hours or bedtime. It's a bit of a productivity force field, and it just helps you scrape back that little bit of time that you might have otherwise spent doom scrolling on Instagram or TikTok throughout the day. So definitely worth a try, in my opinion. 14 is another really great quality of life hack. We all know that pressing the side key and the volume down button will take a screenshot, but by default, nothing is actually assigned to the volume up key and side key. So you can assign an action to the volume up and side key by going into your accessibility settings like so, select the volume up and side key option, and then I've gone ahead and assigned the extra dim mode to this so I can quickly turn this feature on and off whilst I'm sat in bed by just using the keys on the side of the phone. Really great little hack for you. My 15th tip is enhancing a feature that's already on by default, and it's the image upscaler. You might notice when you crop a photo or screenshot, you'll be given the option to upscale it, but by default it doesn't do it to its full potential. So if you go into your gallery settings, go to the detail enhancer, you'll see that you have the option to set it to maximum like so, so you can really get the best out of your S25 Ultra and those images or screenshots you've been taking. Number 16 is another really great quality of life tip. You've likely seen tons of YouTubers point out the various display settings like vibrant mode, full resolution and more, but there is a setting called video brightness under the advanced features, and that not only raises the brightness of videos automatically, but also the vibrancy, so it just makes your videos pop and look that little bit better automatically. Number 17, whilst you are in the advanced features section, is definitely worth heading over to the lab section where you'll see the multi-window for all apps option. I do really recommend turning this feature on as it will make multitasking a little bit easier. It is still in beta, so it might still be a little bit janky for some people, but I haven't had any issues and I've had this turned on since I got the phone. Number 18, heading into the camera settings. Now this is a really great tip, and it really just brings your S25 Ultra up in line with iPhones, and that is the motion photo. So tapping this little icon in the top right will turn this feature on, and it works in a similar fashion to iPhones where you take a photo and then you can kind of scroll through to find the best result. So if someone has blinked during a photo, you can just simply scroll through it and find a version where they've actually got their eyes open. Really great little hack and definitely a setting worth keeping on. Number 19 is perhaps a little bit of a naughty one, but it's read people's WhatsApp messages after they've deleted them. We've all been in that scenario where someone sent a message, deleted it instantly, and you've not quite had time to read it. For me, it just frustrates me. Even if it's nothing bad, I just always want to know what they said, and there is a way to do that. Go to your settings in your S25 Ultra, notifications, advanced settings, and then you'll see notification history. Tap this and turn it on. Now, when you receive a WhatsApp message and someone deletes it, you can simply go to your history and see exactly what that WhatsApp message said. Now, my 20th tip is actually especially on the subject of cases. The S25 Ultra is such an expensive phone and it's absolutely huge. So finding the right case is actually really tough. On one hand, the S25 Ultra is super expensive, so you want to make sure it's protected. But on the other hand, it's also a super big phone, so putting a large case on it is only going to add more heft and bulk. So unfortunately, my top tip is get two cases to alternate between, and I'd recommend two really good cases here. So for me, I've got the mouse case. This is my ultra protective, but adds a little bit of extra bulk case. This is the one that I use when I'm out and about doing sports or in a city, for example. And then on slower days, I use this Arc Pulse case. It looks absolutely exquisite in my opinion, and it adds little to no heft at all to the phone, but it does offer minimal protection. So you've got two options there. I'm going to put them in the pinned comment for you and the description if you want to check them out for yourself, but no obligation, of course. These are just the two cases that I'm alternating between and I'm really enjoying at the moment. Tip number 21, do check out my S25 Ultra review. You can click in the top left or right hand corner now, or even watch my full Galaxy Watch Ultra review. For now though, I've been Alex, this has been Take It Easy. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.